that we have studied what is annealing, what is normalizing. Now, today we are going to discuss one more type of treatment, most important type of treatment, that is hardening and tempering. Part one of that will be discussed today. I am Mr. P. P. Mitragotri, working in Mechanical Engineering Department of Walchand Institute of Technology, Solapur. Outcome of this session will be students will be able to design proper hardening and tempering heat treatment cycle for a given component, because designing of hardening and tempering cycle to get exact set of properties is very, very difficult task is faced by industrial personnel. And then tempering. Hardening, the word itself indicates that hardening is the treatment in which we harden the steel. That is, we transform the steel into martensitic structure by heating it above A3 temperature. First of all, we get austenite, and then austenite is transformed to martensite. And this transformation of austenite to martensite takes place by cooling the steel at a rate greater than critical cooling rate. And for cooling it at a rate greater than critical cooling rate, we have to undercool the austenite to martensitic start temperature, which is generally well below 250 degrees Celsius. Sorry. And due to that, we have no other go than to carry out sudden transformation of austenite to martensite. And in this transformation, we transform FCC structure into BCT structure, that is face-centered cubic structure having C by A ratio of 1 is transformed to C by A ratio 1.04. So transformation of austenite to martensite is accompanied by volume change. It is sudden transformation. It doesn't involve nucleation and growth. It differs from transformation of austenite to ferrite cementite mixture, that is either perlite or bainite. So now at this juncture of time, before proceeding further, I will pose a question before you. That is, whether transformation of austenite to martensite is diffusion type of transformation or diffusionless transformation. And why, if it is diffusionless transformation, why it is so? Now, as already stated, austenite is transformed to martensite by cooling it at a rate greater than critical cooling rate. So first of all, we will discuss what is the temperature range for heating the steel for hardening. We generally heat the steel for hardening by heating hypoeutectoid steel above A3 temperature, 40 to 50 degrees above A3 temperature, and hyper-eutectoid steel 40 to 50 degrees above A1 temperature. Now you may ask me why hyper-eutectoid steel is not heated above A3 temperature. Answer is simple. Above A1 temperature in hyper-eutectoid steel, we have austenite and cementite. Cementite is equally hard to that of martensite. So there is no point in wasting the time by heating the steel above A3 temperature. And after heat treatment, hence or otherwise, we are going to get martensite and cementite, and we are going to get the same hardness. So to save the time and to avoid greater number of stresses, it is always advised to heat hyper-eutectoid steel 40 to 50 degrees above A1 temperature only. Now in hardening, when we are cooling the steel at such a high cooling rate, we are not allowed to cool it in air normally. We have to cool it in water or oil. as a cooling medium, and these will provide very high cooling rate. When our cooling rate is very high, it will introduce temperature stresses. And as already stated, when austenite is transforming to martensite, C by A ratio is changing from 1 to 1.04, which will be accompanied by 4.6% volume change, as a result of which there will be transformation stresses. So after hardening, we have total stresses equal to temperature stresses plus transformation stresses. So stress level of component is very high, and due to that, our component may have a chance of distortion or cracking during hardening. So due care has to be taken while heating the steel and while cooling. And while cooling, many a times we use fixtures and we apply proper cooling time to avoid distortion. Secondly, when we are aiming to harden the steel, after hardening, we may get martensite, but this martensite that we get is very hard. It has high hardness of RC60, Rockwell C scale 60 plus, but at the same time, it is brittle. It has very good strength, but its toughness is low. And in most of the industrial components, along with hardness and strength, we require higher level of toughness. And to get best combination of strength and toughness, it is always necessary to subject hardened steel to a treatment called as tempering. And this tempering will relieve the stresses as well as it will reduce the hardness, but it will improve the toughness considerably. But it is definitely going to reduce the hardness. But reduction in hardness is much lesser as compared to increase in toughness. For example, if a particular steel after normalizing has a tensile strength of 52 kg per mm square and toughness of say 7.2 kg meter, and our component is required to possess a tensile strength of 58 kg per mm square and shall have toughness of 12.4 kg meter. If we harden the same steel and temper at proper temperature, we may get tensile strength of 60 kg per mm square and toughness of 13.2 kg meter. It means that we are able to achieve required level of hardness and required level of strength and required level of toughness by combining proper heat treatment cycle of hardening and tempering. But for that, judicious judgment of stresses developed during hardening is very essential. It is very essential to select proper quenching media. For certain steels, if we employ water as a cooling medium, our steel may get cracked. And if we employ oil as a cooling medium, our steel may not be able to develop required martensitic structure and required set of properties. So proper selection of cooling medium, proper cooling process, and after that, proper tempering cycle is important in getting required set of properties. Mind well, best set of properties is always achieved. Best possible combination of strength and toughness can only be achieved after hardening and tempering. No other treatment is comparable to this treatment. In hardening treatment, we have to carry out heating of steel in a proper condition. our rate of heating must not be excessively high and shall not be too low. And if our component has variable cross section, generally preheating is preferred. In such cases, you preheat the steel to a temperature of 550 to 600, hold there for sufficient period of time, and then heat it finally to the required temperature, and then hold it for sufficient length of time, and cool it in water or oil as per the specification of the steel and get the required set of power. For further reading, I will recommend the book by Dr. V.D. Kodgire, Everest Publication, that is Material Science and Metallurgy, Metallurgy for Engineers by E.C. Rolason, and Introduction to Physical Metallurgy by Evner, TMH Publication. Thank you. Have a nice time.